Hello students, welcome to my educational channel Kingdom of Learning. I am Sunita Diwan, a teacher and a blogger. So every time you open my channel, I promise you to tell something new about English. So today I'm going to explain the poem Not Marble, Not the Gilded Monuments, that is written by William Shakespeare. So first of all, let me tell you something about the poet. William Shakespeare is the most renowned and the most famous poet of English. So he was born in Stratford upon Avon, England. William Shakespeare's works have been performed in countless hamlets, villages, cities and metropolises. He has written so many sonnets, and this is also one of his sonnets. This is his sonnet 55, and this is one of the most famous verses of Shakespeare. So let us know about the theme of this poem. This poem, Not Marble, Not the Gilded Monuments, asserts the immortality of poet's sonnets to withstand the forces of decay over time. Here in this poem, the poet highlights the fact that all the great monuments, memorials, and statues erected by princes, rulers, and the rich people to keep their memory alive are subject to decay, destruction, and deterioration. So, here the poet says that time destroys every monument and memorial, but if you want to keep the memory of somebody alive, you can mention that person in your poetry. So, this poem is set in Old England. So, now let us see the explanation of this poem. The poet says, not marble nor the gilded monuments of princes shall outlive this powerful rhyme. The poet William Shakespeare says that all the monuments, gilded monuments, gilded means gold plated, all the gold plated monuments which are made up of marble, that is a precious stone, of princes, which are made by the princes in the memory of their beloved or their friends, shall not outlive this powerful rhyme. Rhyme here stands for poetry. Means the poet says that he can write a powerful poetry in the memory of his beloved, and that will last longer than the buildings and the monuments which are erected by the kings and princes in the memory of their beloved. But you shall shine more bright in these contents. So the poet says to his friend that you shall shine more bright in these contents. These contents here stands for the content of the poetry which he has written in the praise of his friend. So he assures his friend that you will shine very brightly in my poetry. Shall shine, here we can see the poetic device of alliteration is used. Then unswept stone besmeared with sluttish time. Then unswept stone. Unswept stone means a stone or a monument that is left uncared for. Means the poet means to say that the kings and the princes, they get so many monuments erected in the memory of their beloveds or their friends, but ultimately these monuments are not looked after properly by anybody and they are left uncared for. Besmeared with sluttish time. Besmeared means tarnished. Tarnished means faded. With sluttish time. Sluttish means of unclean habits and behavior. Means here the poet says that these monuments are left uncared for. They become tarnished, they become faded and old with sluttish time. With the passage of time, time that is of unclean and unhealthy habits. So here we can see the reference to sluttish time. Why has the poet called the time to be sluttish? Actually, slut word is used for those ladies, those women who are prostitutes, those women who are of not a single person, not a single man. So they keep on changing their partners. Similarly, time is also of nobody. Time never waits for anybody. Time also always keeps on changing. That is the reason that the poet has used time to be sluttish. So, when wasteful war shall statues overturn? After that, the poet says that when wasteful war will come, means the war is always useless. It never brings anything good with it. And when that wasteful, that destructive war will be there, then all these statues will be overturned. Overturned means broken. Then all the statues will be broken. And broils root out the work of masonry. And broils here stands for fightings or disturbances, etc. in the war. When there will be some fights, they will also root out the work of masonry. The work of masonry here stands for all the buildings, all the monuments erected in the passage of time. Whenever there would be any war or there would be any fighting, all these buildings will be destroyed. Not Mars, his sword, nor war's quick fire shall burn the living record of your memory. But here the poet is showing a contrast. He says that whenever wars will be there, then these materialistic things will be destroyed. Means these buildings will be destroyed. But the living record of the memory of the poet's friend, the living record means this written memory of the life of poet's friend, which continues even after his death, that cannot be destroyed even by Mars. Mars is the god of war. Means even though the god of war himself comes there with the sword in his hand, he cannot even destroy the living record of the memory of poet's friend. Nor war's quick fire shall burn. Even though there is quick fire of war, it can also not burn the record, the memory of the friend of the poet. The poet means to say that all the other materialistic things are bound to be destroyed. But if once you have written a poem in the memory of your friend, nothing can ever destroy it. Against death and all oblivious enmity. Means even death may be there. All oblivious enmity. Oblivious enmity. Enmity means unfriendliness. Unfriendliness, enmity, which is forgetful of everything and so seeks to destroy everything. Even this can also not destroy the record of the poet's friend, which is mentioned in a poem. Shall you pace forth? So the poet says that you shall always stride forward. Means he says that, my friend, you will always go on moving ahead. Your praise shall still find room even in the eyes of all posterity. Means the praise which I have written about you in my poem, that shall still find room. Room means space. Even in the eyes of all posterity. Posterity means the future generations. Means not only this generation, rather all the future generations will also come to know about your praise that has been mentioned by me in this poem. That wear this world out to the ending doom. That wear this world means that all the future generations that will take this world out to the ending doom. Doom here stands for the judgment day, the final doomsday. Means till the doomsday, all the generations on this earth will always read about the praise of poet's friend through that poem which he has written for him. So till the judgment that yourself arise, you live in this and dwell in lover's eyes. So the poet finally says that till the judgment, the day of the last judgment, that yourself arise, that you will always be raised. You live in this, you will always live in this world, and you will dwell, means live in the eyes of all the lovers of this world. Means the poet says that, my friend, the poetry which I have written in your praise, that will always be remembered, that will always be read by all the lovers of the world, because they will always take inspiration from you. And in this way, this poem comes to an end. So I hope you must have understood the poem. If you found it useful, please share it with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe my channel, because it will always assure you of something good in English. And if you are interested in reading motivational and interesting blogs, you can open my website stiryoursoul.in, and the link is provided in the description box. Thank you.